We're going to use a lathe to wind a spring, and what we need is some music wire, and this is the finished product. We're going to take this music wire and we're going to wrap it around a shaft. So if you notice, we have a couple of wraps that are fairly tight together, and then we have a space between the wraps. This is a compression spring, so it's meant to be made smaller. If it was an extension spring, the wraps would likely be quite close together. The difference between this wrap here and the one next to it is an eighth of an inch. So what we're going to do is we're going to set the lathe to a pitch of an eighth of an inch or eight threads to the inch in order to cut this. We're going to take this spring and we're going to put it on a shaft that we make with a hole in it. Now the diameter of this will be smaller than the inside diameter of the spring because it will spring a little bit. So you can see it is a bit sloppy on that, so it might take a little bit of practice in order to figure that out. We're going to take a piece of steel and we're going to cut a groove in it or a guide, and this is what the wire is going to run through. And what we have here is some spring steel or some music wire. So this will end up looking like this spring when we're finished. Okay, in the tool post we have this guide sitting in the tool holder, and you can clearly see the groove on it. We're going to put another plate on top and put the wire through it. And this is just going to help it, just help guide the wire to the spring. So we now have the wire guide in the tool holder, and you can see the groove in the end of it, so the music wire will be pushed through here. And you can see the shaft that we're going to wrap the spring around with the hole perpendicular to the shaft. So we now have this set up in the lathe, and the lathe is set for 8 threads to the inch. The gearbox is set at a high RPM, and the power is shut off on the lathe. So he's just going to put the music wire through the shaft, and then we'll just bend the end of it so it has a little bit of tension when he turns the chuck. He's going to hold a little bit of pressure on the end of the wire so it'll wrap tight around the shaft. And he's just going to pull the chuck a couple of revolutions, wrapping the wire tight around the shaft, and then he'll engage the half nut, and it should move around the shaft at 8 threads per inch or an eighth of an inch pitch. He's engaged the half nut, and you should start to see this wire moving away with an eighth of an inch pitch. You'll probably do a half a dozen wraps, then disengage the half nut and a couple of tight wraps at the far end of this spring. And this will be a compression spring. It's meant to be squeezed together. Now the spring is done being wound. He's just going to take a pair of wire cutters and cut it at the top end, and then he'll cut it off the shaft at the bottom end, and we have a finished spring. Cutting it tight to the bottom of the coil and tight to the top of the coil, and then there's the finished product. So there's the spring done.